My name is Duke Castle. These are 8mm movies that my grandfather, Charles Duncan, took in the early 30s. This is my mother, I believe at Kemper Hall, where she went to high school. She was class president in 1935. Quite an outfit, especially for a teenage girl. And this is Mom with her best friend Deborah Childs on the right. They were best buddies throughout their life. Playing with the dog whose name I think is Shasta. And I believe this is at Mom's home in Washington. And that's my grandmother, Vacia, with her nephew, Ralph Williams. He's the son of Myrtle Williams. There's Mom again. Myrtle was one of Vacia's sisters. We called her Pei. And here she is with my grandfather, Charles, who I called Daddy Kos. And this is Ralph again. And I believe this is Mom's childhood home in Hinsdale. And I think it was 725 Washington Avenue. It's a license plate says 1933 on it. And these are some of Pei's garden club friends. She was quite the clubber, my mother would say. Quite the club lady. Well, somebody's having a drink. And this is Mount Vernon, Missouri, where Pei grew up. Her father was Tom Alexander. They called Papa Tom. That was her home. Here she is with her father, Papa Tom. And this is Ralph again with his father, Dick, who's the husband of Myrtle. Pei was always very shy about having her picture taken. I think this is back in Hinsdale. That's my grandfather's oldest brother, Edward, and his and here's his sister, Ella. The oldest brother, Edward, was, and this is Mom's high school boyfriend, Brooke Vickery. And she says that Chuck Norman and Bud Mead show up briefly in these photos also, but I don't know who is who. This looks like it must be Brooke. Didn't want to be filmed. Mom said was her boyfriend for 3 years in high school. And I'm gathering this was near Lake Michigan, or on Lake Michigan. And here they are burying one of their friends. Shasta again. I'm assuming. Oh, this was a party that Pay and Daddy Coase had where they dressed up like Maggie and Jigs, who are cartoon characters that I've never followed. Here they are, and I guess the bar at Maggie and Jigs was called Dinty Moore's. This is a side of my grandparents I never saw. Making drinks, no less, and yet later they were teetotalers. This is at the home on Washington Avenue, Washington Street, Hinsdale. Sure where. And again, here we go again. Looks like coming out of the house again on Washington with Ralph. Looks like Ralph was there quite a bit. He was the manager of the Spinning Wheel restaurant that my grandparents ran in Hinsdale for many years. Married to a woman named Mary. Although that was later on. Looks like Mom is the one that always did the driving. This is in Arkansas. My grandfather was born in Texarkana, right on the border of Arkansas and Texas. So I think they took a trip down through the South. And this was the rural South in Arkansas, at least in the 1930s. And these were the young woman and her mother went with Pay and Mom to Europe in 1931. And my mother said the woman's name was Virginia. I think there's Virginia with my grandmother. Oh, it says with, yeah, there, and there's her mother, Virginia's mother, with Pay. And this is the home that Daddy Coase lived in. It later became a hospital, the home he lived in Texarkana, in the cotton fields. Still had covered wagons. Now this is Ponca City, where my mother was born and was there for a few years before they, Pay and Daddy Coase moved to Chicago. Daddy Coase had a Ford dealership there and was very successful with it. And it looks like there's an oil fire that was occurring here in Ponca City. lots of oil wells. In fact, my grandfather was 12 years old when he came into the Oklahoma Territory before it was a state with his father, Frank. This looks like the fire, the oil fire. Smoke. That's the same fire or another one. But as far as I know, we're still in Ponca City. And this is the home that Mom lived in Ponca City that my grandfather, according to her, built. Now here we're in Missouri with my grandmother Pei and her sister Carrie. Pei had four sisters, yes, and one brother. Here's Pei with her sisters, Myrtle, Carrie, and Vasta. Vasta was the oldest. And here's Vasta with her husband, Walter Counts, who had only one arm. Here's Pei again with her father, Papa Tom, who Mom always felt very affectionate toward.